RAD is the Robotic Aerial Drone Competition. This tournament right here is the Minnesota State Tournament, and it's the first race we've ever done. All of the teams that'll be in the tournament today, this is the first time they've actually even seen the competition field. Okay, so it's that crazy and that new, but the following is amazing already. We have 13 teams registered pretty much within the last month. This year's event is pretty simple. We're just doing the visual line of sight racing, and we're also doing a package drop. Okay, but these drones coming, going forward, just like the VEX, they'll change the game pieces and the games every year, and it'll get more complicated and a little tougher as we go.
Drones are going to disrupt and transform our quality of life in many different ways, and they're already currently doing it. We'll just see the integration make it more and more ubiquitous. So right now we're using them for all different kinds of things. Mainly safety is kind of the number one thing. So I can go and inspect a roof while standing on the ground. I don't have to get harnessed up. I don't have to climb a ladder. So I can do that and keep people safe while still performing the jobs that need to get done.
We feel drone technology, obviously you're seeing it explode. I mean, just from a couple years ago, it's gone crazy. Law enforcement uses them. Ag, where we're at, agriculture side is huge. Power line inspections, infrastructure, bridges. But the skill sets that we see going forward, obviously the autonomous side, the computer programming, that's gonna be a huge skill set going forward in the future. All those kind of things are what kids are definitely gonna need going forward.
Some of the skills that they learn at the competition, the biggest one is a soft skill, is about communication. In the competition, the students have to work with spotters, the driver or the flyer. He has to rely on his spotters to help him know or her know where they're dropping it. The other things they're working on is they can eventually be able to program their drone, and programming is an important skill that most people don't realize, that it teaches them problem-solving skills. So that's really important because they can go and crash and come back and say, okay, we gotta try it over again. And they go at it and they find that they get successful at it.
We enjoy being a team. Like, it's nice having just a few people, and we all three work together good. And it's just fun to get the experience together and like learn about different things.
I wanna go into like aircraft and things like that. And it's just, you know, it'll help out. You can learn some things that you don't have to maybe pay for. And I think it's fun to learn.
I would encourage anybody to be a coach, whether it's robotics, drone racing. Overall, they are so young, and as you see them grow throughout the years, it's really rewarding. And of course, you don't see it in money, you just see it in the smiles, you see it in the way that they carry themselves. And in years and years, they come back and they usually thank you. And it's really worth it for that.
If somebody really wants to get into the RAD or the drone competition, all they have to do is go to roboevents.com. They can go to the REC website, or they can just look up RAD. So very easy to find information.